just got an email asking about sleep and the notion that sleep is twice as beneficial before midnight as it is after midnight. And the question was, why is that? How do we know that? Now, sleep is interesting because it's a very dynamic topic, very complex. And actually, addressing sleep from the standpoint that we only sleep once per day is actually an... what would be the word? It is an incomplete diagnosis of this very important thing that we do that we call sleep. Because the natural and more beneficial way to sleep would be to sleep multiple times in a singular 24-hour period, in a single 24-hour period. So that is otherwise known as polyphasic sleep. But we're going to address this from a one-time sleep pattern. So it has a lot to do with ultradian rhythms. Ultradian rhythms are much like circadian rhythms, but circadian rhythms are the rhythms that our body goes through every 24 hours, and ultradian rhythms are the rhythms that our body goes through every few minutes to every hour or so. And an example of that would be the fact that our body switches dominant nostrils every few minutes because a different nostril does a different task in the body. For instance, the left side of the nostril, the left air that goes in the left nostril is actually going to be associated with the left channels of the body, which have to do with intaking energy, subtle energy. And the right side of the body has to do with excreting toxins and life force energy that we don't need. Anyways, so sleeping, going to sleep when the sun goes down, there's a bunch of ultradian and circadian rhythms that change and shift when the sun sets. So if you can imagine going to sleep when the sun sets, don't hit me, when the sun sets, then there's a bunch of normal natural cycles that are going to get started. And if you were to stay up, let's say to midnight after the sun sets, all of those normal processes wouldn't happen. All of those, the circadian rhythms wouldn't get started. Now, what would happen though is that the body pretty much starts to do the opposite. So, for example, when you go to sleep, your body starts to convert norepinephrine, which is norepinephrine is the cousin, it's the lesser version of epinephrine, and epinephrine is adrenaline. Norepinephrine keeps you awake during the day. And when you go to sleep, your body takes norepinephrine and it converts it to melatonin. So if you stay up past the sunset, your body's still producing norepinephrine, especially, I'm gonna make a turn here, especially if you are staring into screens and or sitting underneath artificial light, your body's gonna think it's not only awake, bro, just gonna go through a red light. Not only awake, it's going to think that it's in sunlight. So what's happening when you stay up is your body's continuing to produce the hormone that keeps you up, and it's actually not producing the hormone that is supposed to be produced when you go to sleep. And we can really get into what melatonin is. Melatonin's produced, synthesized, I should say, by the pineal gland from norepinephrine. And it's coded by the amount of light we have during the day. So the amount of light exposure we have during the day is communicating with the pineal gland. The pineal gland opens up, releases melatonin, and as an open channel, the pineal gland, it opens up to the cosmic landscape of information. And it channels that information into the body and it restructures ourselves on a cellular level, at an energetic frequency level. So if we really think in energetics, that we're not made of like little pieces of particles and that we're actually made of waveforms, and these waveforms need to be harmonized every night, that is the action of the pineal gland, melatonin, and we interpret these waves of energies as dreams. Now, the point is that if we're staying up past sunset, we are impeding the body's ability to do these things naturally. And that doesn't mean that it is wrong or bad, because there's a lot of people that know this about herself, know the thing about the pineal gland, and or just intuitively know that if you stay up all night, right, if we hack the system, and or this is where polyphasic sleep comes in play, because you don't have to sleep for 8 hours at night, because it's the only time you can sleep for 4 hours, then be up and then have access to the codes that I was just speaking of, which is why creative people and artists and writers and anybody that needs to produce using sources outside of themselves, meditators also, even if we're not producing, we're wanting an experience. Meditation happens best early in the morning, right? 3 a.m., 4 a.m., 5 a.m., and we get access to the codes, the same codes that are coming in to repair our body every night. I don't know what question I'm answering, but it was just a conversation about going to sleep before midnight versus after midnight and the sleep. Oh, so if the sleep, if you stay up really long after the sun sets, then the sleep that you get, like let's say you go to bed at midnight, well, that midnight sleep, midnight to 7 a.m. sleep, is going to be not as beneficial as if you went to bed at 8 p.m. Because if you went to bed at 8 p.m., all of your hormones would be aligned and switched over, and it would make all of your sleep much more functional. If we wait, it pretty much introduces dysfunction in the patterns, and that dysfunction is going to remain through the rest of your sleep. And I hopefully am gonna make it home alive. Bye bye.